In this episode of FTD Facts, I'm taking a look at the phenomenal multi-role fighter jet known as the HAL Tejas. My name is Leroy Kenton, and leave a like on this video if you're proud of the nation that you come from. Like really, I want to see like a lot of likes on this video. So the HAL Tejas has made the nation of India very proud when it was inducted into service. So let's jump right into the facts and let's take a look and see what this aircraft is all about. The Tejas is a single seat, single jet engine, multi-role, lightweight, supersonic fighter jet. The power plant used in the Tejas is General Electric F404GE F2J3 turbofan engines with afterburn. Of course, that provides an increase in the thrust for the aircraft, which is pretty important, especially when you are dealing with fighter aircraft combat. The Tejas can hit a top speed of Mach 1.8, which is 2,205 kilometers per hour, and it can fly at a maximum altitude at 15,200 meters. The range of the Tejas is 3,000 kilometers, and the aircraft weighs approximately 5,450 kilograms. Now, depending on the variant, it'll cost you anywhere between $23 million and $40 million to produce one of these jets. But those dollars are really put to good use when it comes to its stealth technology. Stealth is a really important thing that's needed in aircraft development, considering that all major militaries in the world are investing a lot of money in radars to detect enemy aircraft. The idea is to keep the radar cross section, or the RCS, as low as possible. And RCS, if you don't know, is a measure of how detectable something is by radar. The Tejas shows off various features to keep the RCS as low as possible. Some of these features include Y-shaped air inlets. Also, it has a lot of composite materials that are used in the design, and these do not reflect radar waves, which increases its undetectability. The Tejas also has a coating of radar absorbing materials over the control surfaces. But you know, even if the aircraft is detected, one of the great things about the Tejas is that it was designed to be unstable. Tejas has a delta wing configuration, which are wings shaped like a triangle with no tail planes or canard and a single dorsal fin. Now, this can be used as an advantage. You see, the unstable design makes it a lot easier to maneuver, and it gives it a major advantage over competing jets when it comes to performance in dogfights. And you could see this thing, it just shoots through the sky. Like, it's up, it's down, it's left, it's right, it's forward, back. Okay, I'm exaggerating a little bit, but that thing can move. The Tejas also has 8 weapon hardpoints. It has 3 under each wing, 1 under the central body, and 1 under the air inlets on the left side of the aircraft. This gives the Tejas the ability to use a pretty wide range of weapons. Some of these weapons include mid and close range air-to-air missiles, precision guided weapons, air-to-surface missiles, conventional bombs, cluster bombs, and unguided rockets. It also can carry a maximum of 4 tons of weapons. This is also in addition to its main gun, which is a 23mm twin-barreled cannon with 220 rounds. So the Tejas comes pretty decked out, and the capability of any aircraft has to go through a lot of intense training before it can get approved and finalized and be ready for combat. It is no different for the Tejas prototype. So these prototypes had been put through over 1,000 test flights and over 530 hours of flight testing by January of 2009. So fast forward 4 years now, in the year 2013 alone, there were over 450 test flights for its prototypes. The prototypes also went through very intense hot weather training as well as cold weather tests to ensure that the aircraft doesn't crap out on you when you're in combat. The construction of the Tejas was planned way back in the day, like as early as 1980s as a matter of fact. It was to replace the MiG-21s of the Indian Air Force, which were inducted in the early 1960s. So of course it was time for a replacement. And in the year 1984, the government of India decided to start the process of building an indigenous aircraft. Aeronautical Development Agency, or the ADA, was set up by the government for aircraft development. Tejas is India's first indigenous aircraft designed by the ADA and produced by the Hindustan Aeronautical Limited, or HAL, or some people just say HAL. The Tejas was the second supersonic fighter developed by HAL. The induction of this aircraft was also a long time coming. Like, it took about 33 years to get inducted in the military. It had taken its first flight in January 4th of 2001, and it was given the name Tejas by Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee in the year 2003. And in Sanskrit, the word Tejas means radiance, which is a very fitting name, especially how it dominates the sky. Then finally, after years and years and years and years of development, testing, and delays, in July 2016, two HAL Tejas fighter jets were inducted into the Indian Air Force, specifically inducted into a squadron known as Flying Daggers 45. And the last thing I want to share with you is that in 2016, the Tejas participated in its first foreign show at the Bahrain International Air Show. And there was some big drama caused because it was compared to the JF-17 Thunder, which is Pakistan's fighter jet that's produced by Pakistan with the help of China. So it's a big debate, like, which aircraft is better? Like, it's still going on. Anyways, that's another topic for another video. For more videos about the military of India and other nations, you gotta click the video right here to keep on learning. We post videos daily here on FTD Facts about countries and culture and people of our world. So show that subscribe button some love and ring that bell notification so you don't miss any future episodes. Okay, that's it for me. My name is Leroy Kenton, and I'll see you all next time in another episode.